continue our previous discussion by adding a few more parameters. So let's talk about Mahesh, our farmer's costs. A few assumptions that we are going to make today is that farmer Mahesh must pay rupees 1000 per month for the land, regardless of how much wheat he grows. A second assumption we are making is that he also pays rupees 2000 per month for every farm worker he hires. Now, with these two assumptions in place, let's see how this impacts the wheat he produces. So, if you pay attention to the table over here, cost of land is rupees 1000, irrespective of how many workers he hires or how many tons of wheat he grows. So it stays the same all the time. Cost of labor varies depending on how many workers he hires. Remember, the assumption we made was that he has to pay rupees 2000 per month for every worker, which means for every additional worker it goes on doubling. So 2000 becomes 4000. For the third worker it goes on to become another additional 2000 rupees, so it's 6000, 8000, and at 5 workers he reaches 10,000 rupees to be paid as the monthly salary or wages to the farm hands. So the total cost that is incurring is the sum of the land cost and the cost of labor. So even when he is not growing anything, he still has to pay rupees 1000 for the land. So that stays. When he is hiring one worker, his total cost comes to 1000 for land and 2000 for the wages of the single worker. So it comes to rupees 3000. And the rest of the column is pretty much on the similar lines. Now let's try and calculate the total cost curve of farmer Mahesh. So if you look at the cost curve based on the data presented in the table previously, the chart would look something like this. So initially, when the quantity of wheat is about 1000 or 2000 tons, the total cost incurred by farmer Mahesh is gradually seen to be increasing. But as he tries to increase his output, keeping the amount of land fixed, for every additional amount of wheat that he wishes to grow, the total cost starts increasing almost exponentially. So what is this concept of marginal cost? Marginal cost is the increase in the total cost from producing one more unit. So marginal cost can be defined as the extra cost, the total cost that's incurred for every additional unit that needs to be generated from the resources available. So mathematically speaking, marginal cost would be defined as the ratio of the change in total cost over the change in quantity. So it's the change in total cost divided by the change in quantity. So let's apply this to the data we have in the table. So we start off with two columns, that's quantity and the total cost incurred, and let's see what happens to the marginal cost. So initially, for the first two rows, the total cost has changed from rupees 1000 to rupees 3000. So the change in total cost is 3000 rupees minus 1000 rupees. So delta TC, or the change in total cost, is 2000 rupees. For the same scenario, what would be the change in quantity? So quantity changed from 0 to 1000. So it's 1000 minus 0 gives us the change in quantity, or delta Q. So the ratio of this over this is 2000 divided by 1000, which gives us the marginal cost. So the marginal cost of producing extra wheat, or 1000 tons of wheat, is rupees 2. For the next set, when the total cost rises from 3000 to 5000, remember the reason the total cost has jumped from 3000 to rupees 5000 is because farmer Mahesh decided to hire one extra person to work on his farm. So again, the change in the total cost is 5000 minus 3000, which is just 2000, but the increase in quantity from 1000 to 1800 resulted in a change of quantity of just 800. So now it's 2000 divided by 800. So the marginal cost has now increased from 2 rupees to 2 rupees 50 paise. Similarly, if we go to the next stage, again the rise in total cost is just another rupees 2000, because an extra farm hand has been hired, and the change in the wheat output has just increased by 600 tons, which means 2000 divided by 600 gives us the marginal cost as rupees 3.33. Similarly, going on to calculate for the next two stages, we see that the marginal cost increases to 5 rupees and then on to become rupees 10. So initially you can see the marginal cost rose from 2 to 2 rupees 50 paisa, then it rose from 250 to 3.33, and then it started rising almost exponential. So 3.33 became 5, 5 doubled to become 10, and the trend will continue further. So given our calculation of marginal cost column, we come to a few conclusions. One, marginal cost usually rises as Q rises, right? So that's very much clear. The marginal cost rises with rise in quantity. Next, let's talk about fixed and variable costs. So fixed cost, as you might have guessed, is something that does not vary with the quantity of output produced. So in the case of the example we have been referring to, the fixed cost that farmer Mahesh pays every month for his land of rupees 1000 does not vary irrespective of how much output he is able to get from his land. Other similar examples for fixed costs would be cost of equipment, loan payments, rent, electricity charges, and so on. Then there are variable costs, which vary with the quantity being produced. So the wages, for example, that farmer Mahesh pays is a variable cost, because as he tries to get more and more output, he has to hire extra labor to help him on his farm. So that is a variable cost. So other examples would be cost of materials. So typically he would need more seeds, you would need more fertilizers and manure, you would need more insecticides, pesticides, you would need more water. So all these would be part of the variable costs. Now the total cost then would come out to be the sum of these two costs. It is fixed cost plus variable cost would give you Farmer Mahesh's total cost. Let's look at yet another example. This time we'll pick up an example which is applicable to any type of firm. Our first example was quite simplistic in nature, whereas the second example would be applicable to any type of firm which is involved in producing any type of goods with any types of inputs. So let's make some assumptions initially. So let's assume we are a firm which encounters a fixed cost of rupees 100 for every quantity. So that does not vary, it's a fixed cost. So plotting the fixed cost line would be pretty straightforward. You'll get a straight line that's parallel to the x-axis, since all the costs are rupees 100 at any quantity you produce. Then we have variable costs. So I have put in some random numbers with the general rising trend, because variable costs, as we just found out, will increase because of the additional quantity of materials or raw materials that are required as we try to produce more output. So with every quantity increase, there's a general increasing trend in the variable costs. So plotting that, you'll see that generally there's a rising trend seen in the variable cost curve. So obviously the total cost curve would also be something similar to the lines of the variable cost curve, just that we'll have to figure out that we need to add up the fixed costs as well. So calculating total cost would give us a curve indicated in green. So this would be pretty much obvious for this example. So you have a flat line for a fixed cost, you have a generally increasing trend seen for variable costs, and the total cost would obviously follow a general increasing trend. Now what about marginal cost? So let's calculate marginal cost for this example. So I take the total cost as my column number 2, and the marginal cost would be the difference between every successive row and the previous row for column number 2. So it's 170 rupees minus 100. So the marginal cost when I move from quantity 0 to quantity 1 is rupees 70. Next, I increase the total cost to 220, hence my marginal cost is 220 minus 170, rupees 50. So you'll see that initially the marginal cost goes on decreasing, but eventually at some stage it plateaus out and then you see an increasing trend. So why does this happen? The marginal cost starts rising as quantity rises, partly due to the diminishing marginal product. Because the marginal product decreases, there is an increase in the marginal cost. And in special cases like the one over here, there's an initial drop in marginal cost followed by a subsequent increase. But the general case that we always see, which is applicable to all the cases, is that marginal cost rises as quantity rises because of the diminishing marginal product. There are other few examples too, which we'll study later, wherein the marginal cost may be constant. Those are certain special cases we'll consider later on. Now let's also study yet another concept called the average fixed cost. So in fixed cost is rupees 100 for whatever quantity is being produced. What do you think will be the average fixed cost? So average fixed cost is the total cost, fixed cost, divided by the quantity being produced. So fixed cost divided by the quantity being produced. So what do you think will happen to the average fixed cost? As you rightly might have guessed, the fixed costs get distributed over larger and larger quantities, and hence the average fixed cost starts dropping. So you can see clearly in my column, for the first quantity the fixed cost is 100, and average fixed cost is 100 divided by 1, which is 100. When my quantity increases to 2, the same fixed cost of 100 is now divided by 2 units, so it becomes 50. At 3 it becomes 33.33, at 4 it becomes 25, then 20, then 16.67, and finally 14.29 at a total production of 7 units. So as Q rises, we notice that the average fixed cost falls. And the reasons being simple, we are spreading out the fixed cost over larger and larger number of units. Now what happens to our average variable cost? So we considered average fixed cost and we found out that it falls as the number of quantities increases. But what happens to the average variable cost? So I have taken the variable cost as my second column. Again, the definition of average variable cost is variable cost divided by the quantity. So when we perform the computations, we find 70 divided by 1 is 70 initially. Then a variable cost rises to 2, rises to 120. So 120 divided by 2 is 60. Then it rises to 160. 160 divided by 3 is 53.33. So you see that there is a decreasing trend. But somewhere along the line, the trend reverses direction. 52.5 is the lowest we get to. And for the fifth quantity, the average variable cost has become 56, which is greater than 52.5. And at quantity 6, it further rises to 63.33. And at quantity 7, it goes on to become almost 75 rupees. So what you see is that average variable cost may fall initially. It may fall initially, but in most cases, average variable cost will eventually rise as the output rises. Now let's come to one more concept, which is the average total cost. So we talked about average fixed cost, we talked about average variable cost, and now we are talking about average total cost. So I take the total cost column as my second column and I compute the average total cost. Again, before computing, let's try and define what would be mathematically the definition for average total cost. So it would be total cost divided by the quantity. So based on that, my computation gives me 170 at quantity 1, it falls to 110 at quantity 2, falls further to 86.67, further to 77.5, then further on to 76, but then you see a reversal in the trend. It increases to 80 and then 88.57. So again, we notice this being the case partly because average total cost is average fixed cost plus average variable cost. So average fixed cost went on decreasing because we were spreading out the fixed cost over larger and larger number of units. But average variable cost, though there was an initial fall, it eventually started rising because for every additional input output that needed to be produced, we needed more and more input resources. So obviously, average total cost being the sum of these two will find a similar trend, which is it falls initially and then it starts rising. So let's try and plot some of these in a few moments. So usually, as in this example, the average total cost, you will notice, is U-shaped. So your average total cost is a typical U-shaped curve. It falls initially and then rises. Now let's try and put all the cost curves together. So the average total cost curve is something that you've already seen. This is my average variable cost curve. So that too started off by falling and eventually it started rising. My average fixed cost continuously falls all the time. And finally, the marginal cost. So the marginal cost initially falls in this case, but then it starts rising almost exponentially, which means to say that for every additional quantity that we are producing or that we wish to produce, the marginal cost of producing every additional unit becomes larger and larger.